Some crystalline salts, some substances in our daily use which contain water of crystallization. One, alum, potash alum, K2SO4, Al2, SO43, 24H2O. Two, borax, Na2B4O7, 10H2O. Three, Epsom salt, magnesium sulfate, MgSO4, 7H2O. Four, barium chloride, BaCl2, 2H2O. Five, sodium sulfate, Glauber salt, Na2SO4, 10H2O.
So you learned about water crystallization in chapter number 5 again. So you see, this chapter got a lot of connection with chapter 5, acids, bases and salts, in the first semester which you learned. So what happens, you see that some substances, they have a crystalline shape. The salts have a crystalline shape. Why? Because the water of crystallization. Like we saw, blue vitriol. Blue vitriol is crystalline in nature. Blue vitriol is copper sulfate. It is blue color and crystalline. Why? Because of the water crystallization. We saw it had in the chapter 5, we saw it had five molecules of water of crystallization. And these five molecules of water of crystallization gave it its shape and color. But when these crystalline salts, they are heated or sometimes exposed to air, they lose the water of crystallization and they become amorphous, or they lose the shape and they become amorphous, or you can say they lose color also and they lose the shape also. For example, we saw in the chapter number 5 when this copper sulfate, or what you call blue vitriol, was heated, the crystals of copper sulfate were heated, or blue vitriol were heated, it turned into white amorphous powder, amorphous or anhydrous powder. Okay, so, and just to give an example, what is crystalline? Crystalline is something like a sugar. No, you have sugar in your house, you eat that sugar. So those sugar, it is crystalline. No? You can see it is cubical shape, small sugar crystals. It has got a shape. Whereas the talcum powder which you use for your face, which you put for, on your face, you use talcum powder, that is amorphous. It has no shape. It is very smooth, very fine. So salt, cooking salt, sugar and all, they are crystalline in nature. But sugar is not a salt. Huh? Sugar is a substance which is crystalline. I'm just one example. Whereas, okay. So let's continue.
We have learned that alum is used in the process of water purification because of property of coagulation. The solid impurities in water come together, become heavy, and settle to the bottom. As a result, the water above becomes clear.
So, sometimes if you feel the water is quite muddy, what you can do is simply take some alum pieces. Alum is what you call in Marathi, they call it turti. Okay, so you can put that alum in the water and slowly, slowly all the muddy particles will settle down. And then you can just filter it out and use that water. Okay, it becomes portable. You can use it for whatever purpose you want to use it. Okay, but don't forget to boil it. That will only remove the mud. But alum will only settle down the mud which is there in the water. But the germs will still be there. Okay, so you'll also have to boil it and then use it for drinking. And you have also seen nowadays, of course, nobody uses that so much, but in the barber shop, they use alum, the shaving, shaving alum, for the after shaving, they put that, they have a small block of alum which they put on your face. Why? Because the alum has got a disinfectant property also, it kills the germs to some extent. That's why we added alum to muddy water, I told you just now. So that is one use of alum, which can also use it by it. The barbers also use it, and it's used also for settling down in the all the muddy impurities if the water is quite muddy.
Blue vitriol is used in the blood test for diagnosing anemia. In the Bordeaux mixture, which is used as a fungicide on fruits like grapes, musk melon, slacked lime, it is used with blue vitriol.
So if you mix blue vitriol with slaked lime, what is slaked lime? I told you slaked lime is nothing but calcium hydroxide. If you mix slaked lime and copper sulfate or blue vitriol, you get something called as a Bordeaux mixture, which is used as a fungicide or to kill all the insects or the germs which grow on the, especially on the fruit trees, it's called a Bordeaux mixture. So let's proceed.
So when oil or animal fat is boiled with an aqueous solution of sodium or potassium hydroxide, sodium or potassium salts of carboxylic acids, fatty acids are formed. These salts are called soap. When soap is mixed with hard water, calcium and magnesium salts of fatty acids are formed. These being water insoluble, they form a precipitate, and that is why lather is not formed.
So we all had learned in the lower classes, and we saw it a little before this, that soap does not form lather or foam or jhag, no? In the, usually when you put a detergent powder in the water, you see it forms a lot of lather, jhag aata hai. But we all have learned that soap does not form lather in hard water. What you get in your house, in your tap, that is soft water. So that's why that soap easily forms lather. But if you take well water, which is hard water, it did not form lather. And what is the reason we saw? We just saw. Okay, that was the reason for it. So that's one important question which will be asked, which you have to learn, which will be asked in the exam. Why does soap not form lather in hard water? Okay, so the answer you just saw. So keep that in mind.
Complete the table by writing the differences between bathing soap and washing soap.
So in bathing soap, we use high grade fats and oils. Okay, high quality fats and oils. Washing soap, we use very chalu quality or low quality fats and oils. And bathing soap, potassium hydroxide is used, which is a little less stronger base, whereas in washing soap we use sodium hydroxide, which is a little stronger base. And bathing soap is free from alkali content. It is free from alkali content, so it doesn't cause any injury to skin, whereas washing soap, it has a lot of free alkali content, a lot of alkalis, which helps in the cleaning. That's why we saw sodium hydroxide with a strong base, no? So it got a lot of free alkali which helps in cleaning or to remove the dirt or to, there are some germs, maybe kill the germs also. And there's one more difference also, that bathing soap, they use expensive perfumes, no? They put a lot of expensive perfume in the bathing soap, no? We buy the soap after smelling the soap, no? If you so bathing soap, that's why they use the best expensive perfumes they add it to the bathing soap, because they know that people like to buy the bathing soap because of the fragrance. Whereas washing soap, we don't smell washing soap, we're not interested in the fragrance or whatever, because we don't use it for your bodies. Whereas the bathing soaps are used for bodies.